Marc Preston, I know that you are the Australian man that like challenges, and this is a very important challenge in your life, I think.
Yeah, it's really great to be joining DS now as DS Techeetah. It's a really big challenge now, as we know. The series is really growing up. It's been an exciting first 4 years, and we had a great year last year, obviously winning the Drivers' Championship. But now, you know, moving on, it's the challenge gets bigger, and with that challenge, we're obviously joining with a great car manufacturer in DS Automobiles, and we hope that this next season is just as good as last, and maybe that little bit better with a team's championship as well.
So this is the first time that it's unveiled a new car with the new team and all things. But you know, we know very well that you are working since a lot of time. What you can say about this completely new era of Formula E?
Yeah, I mean, the completely new era of Formula E is really interesting, isn't it? Because we go from two cars, driver changes, to now one car, one of the biggest changes. That brings with it all sorts of operational stresses, let's say, on the team, because the driver only has one car. If there was any problems in during a day, that puts more pressure. But now that the car can finish the entire race, strategies change. There's some new rules coming in next season, which will make it all very exciting. So there's a lot of change, but we're moving forward, and the cars are getting quicker and more exciting. And the challenge is going to be bigger as well.
And all these changements, it's been also changes in the internal part of the paddock, because there are other people that work in other things. There are no more change in the middle of the race. And how do you organize all?
Yeah, I mean, as we move into next year, we're working away in the background on the simulator. I think the general philosophy of operating the team won't change much. We still have the same amount of passes at the track. We're still going to similar tracks. They're similar style of tracks, but now that the challenge means that we don't have the pit stop in the middle, so that'll change the strategy quite a lot. The guys are working really hard in the background, working on the new rules, trying to figure out how we should go about it. The drivers are obviously practicing, trying to understand the new rules and understand the new requirements that they have during the race.
Speaking informally, I told you that I think, in my opinion, that you make a miracle last season, because it was a customer team. You can't stay in Valencia, as example. Yeah. You can't test anything. Now you are supported by a very big reality like DS Automobile, that is part of a PSA group. Yeah. It's a very nice growing for the team, for you. And I think that in Valencia you will be the first time with Formula E, and it will be something new for you.
Yeah, it's going to be a new experience for us, actually, going into the first combined test, having already done some preparation, as you say, in the previous years. We've had a difficult time, obviously, turning up at the combined test and having to do all of our work. It's going to be a great step forward. It's nice having coming off the back of winning a race series to go into the next year with some really big positive changes. Those really big positive changes is how you win in motor racing, and so the stage is set for an exciting year in season five. So we're looking forward to it, and I think we've got all the pieces of the puzzle, and let's see in Valencia.
Yes, we see in Valencia, and you are in the Formula E since the first season with other team. But it's mean that you believe since the first race in Formula E. How much allow to grow professionally the Formula E with the new problematic questions about the races, about the energy, about all?
I mean, when we think back to when we first started in Formula E, a lot of people thought that we wouldn't even make it to the first race in Beijing. So to look back only 4 years ago to see where we've come to now is maybe a minor miracle in itself, but it's also part of being part of a pioneering sport. We've all talked about over the past that, you know, motorsport's supposed to lead the future. I think we're leading the future in Formula E. We've come a long way in those 4 years, and I think we're going to go a long way in the next few years. This, you know, moving down to one car per driver is a nice big step. I think there'll be more things that happen in the future, and let's wait and see, but it's going to be an exciting year and an exciting growth over the next few years.
Thank you very much, and see you in Valencia.
Thank you very much.